Good morning. I have kept this a surprise for such a long time. So yeah, welcome to my channel, welcome to the video. My name is Ian. If you haven't watched me before, welcome. Thank you for clicking on the video. Today is going to be Embarkation Day. This is my second ever Disney cruise. Only a few weeks ago, I went on my very first one on the Disney Wish in Florida. Incredible time, absolutely incredible experience. This trip, however, was actually booked before that one, so it's been very hard not to slip up and say anything. If you have followed me for a while, I actually drove and visited and went to see the Magic, I think it was, Disney Magic, at Greenock in Glasgow. And ever since that day, I wanted to get on that ship, or a Disney ship, like today, the Dream, and it's going round the UK, that one that I wanted to go on. So yeah, join me today. This is the Embarkation Day, cannot wait. Haven't been on the Dream before, like I say. I have been on a Disney ship, I can say that now, but every ship is different, and yeah, I don't know what to expect, of course, but I'm gonna make the most of it. I'm gonna enjoy every second of it. I do have some surprises on the way on the ship, and it's going to be for 7 nights as well, so it's a long cruise. And yeah, a few stops. I'm going to cover the stops probably later on in the video. Let's get on the ship and I'll cover all that. But I'm going to leave my hotel just now. I stayed the night before yesterday. I've done a small vlog yesterday, so I'm releasing the two videos at the same time, like pre-travel day down to Southampton, if you're looking to fly down from Scotland like I did, just to give you some idea of how that goes. So these two videos are up at the same time. But yeah, join me today. Hit subscribe for all these videos coming up. And yeah, I cannot wait to show you what I've got installed. So let's go and have an awesome trip, an amazing day, first and foremost today, Embarkation Day here in Southampton. Let's go. So if you have seen yesterday's video, then you'll know the weather yesterday was awesome. Today, not looking so great. As long as the day's dry, that's what I'm hoping. You never know. I think it actually needs to rain. I don't know if it rained during the night. It looked like it did rain during the night. The weather forecast does look decent enough for the UK, so hopefully it holds out. And I am actually wearing my t-shirt, my Disney Wish t-shirt that I got on the Disney Wish. It's a little dark. But yeah, I'm just about to get packed up. I have a boarding time of 1 p.m. Just getting packed up, get changed. I've been showered, changed, too excited. Woke up early. Let's go, let's do this. But I need to wait a little bit. It's a short walk. I walked last night. I kind of know where I'm going, I think. I'm hoping, because the ship is actually there now. It wasn't there last night. That it's there now. There's more signs to say that's where to go, because I'm going to walk over and hopefully I can walk to the terminal. That's the plan. So I'm going to get packed up and I'm going to head out the hotel and walk on over. So let's go. So I am a bit early still to go to the ship, but I have to check out my room for 11 a.m. and it's just after 11 a.m. I'm in the mezzanine section of the hotel. I'm going to chill for a bit before walking over to find the ship. I'm just going to chill in the lobby just now. I found a very comfortable seat, so hopefully I get up. I'm going to get a taxi over to the QE2 terminal, I believe, where the cruise ship is, because it's starting to rain. I would like to walk over, but it's raining and I'm not going to get soaked before going on the ship. So it is still raining and I'm going to get an Uber. I tried the local taxis yesterday, which was good, but I'm going to get an Uber just now and go to the Queen Elizabeth terminal, Queen Elizabeth II cruise terminal, I believe the ship is. So yeah, going to get this booked and head on over. Cheers. You alright, mate?
Hi.
Cheers, thank you.
Hi, Paul. Thank you.
There we are. Arrived.
High five.
High five.
High four.
High four.
So what, I'm going to go and get checked in, get through security, and I'll see you all when I'm boarding the ship.
That was very busy, very, very busy. Zoom in. Yeah, checked in. And I think I'm just going to the wait area for my boarding to start.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. Right, let's go through security and then go on board. So quickly through security, in the quickest security check I have had, and there it is, the Disney Dream. I don't care if it's raining. So cool, getting back on a Disney ship. Oh, it is absolutely huge. Focus in the same behind me. It is massive. It is such a big ship from the outside. Look at that. The wish was huge as well. Cruising just yet, but it looks big. Anyway, let's go on board. Here we go, nearly on board. Officially.
Mini Mouse.
Please welcome aboard Ian. Woo.
This is totally different to the wish. Oh, I have reached the Walt Disney Theatre. Get so many things about this. There's Mickey. Right, I'm on deck 4. I'm going to go to deck 11. Look at that. There we go, give me the detail for me. I love this. Oh, I tripped over. Right, deck 11. Oh, I just love being here now. It's just kicked in. It's just kicked in. Oh. Right. I don't care if it's raining. I don't, all for the camera, but if it's raining, I'm still going outside. Stairs. I'm hoping it leads to the front or the back of the ship. I'm going to get confused again. I've got to take a obligatory photo right here, right now. I'm going to get my photo. I don't know why I'm so excited to get my photo taken at this spot, but I'm going to get my photo taken and I'll put it on my Instagram. So check out my Instagram if you want to see the photo. Yeah, it's quiet now, but there's waves. bar. Of course, nobody's sitting outside just now. Photo time.
I'm going up some more stairs, see what else is going on.
There's a play area here, Goofy's Sports. We've got outdoor basketball court. And I'm sure they'll do other things as well. Look at that. I don't want to show off my skills too early. So I've got another slide. Is that called Aquamouse from here as well? I'm going to start comparing everything to the Disney Wish now. I don't know what that's the only thing I can compare it to. We do get some views here, they're good views. Of the ship. What's going on here? So you can. I found that out last time in the wish. You can fill your water up here as well. So refilling area for your water. There's your golf. The golf bags. Little mini golf going on here. Goofy's Sports Simulator. Check that out as the trip goes on. Like I say, I'm here for 7 days, so a lot. I'm not going to try and cram it all in immediately, but oh yes, am I walking through big puddles? Yes I am. Why am I doing that? Table football as well. No swimming, no diving, no fishing. This is awesome. This is really, really cool. Let's be right here. Actually quite a lot of little putting areas you can play along. Little course, so give that a go again as the trip goes on.
I would highly, highly recommend getting in very early to your queue for check-in. Even I was 1 p.m. and I got there about 11:30, 12, and I waited. I was at the front of my, they put you into your time slots and the queues and you wait your turn, but you want to be in the front or close to the front and you can get straight through. But yeah, it wasn't too bad. I thought it was going to be a bit chaos, but it wasn't too bad. It's coming up for, it's 1:45 just now. And I'm on board, my room will be ready just now. I think they said about 1:30, so yeah, I mean, I'm not going to complain. I'm on a Disney ship, come on.
If you've been following me for a while, I don't really complain. I try and make the best of things. When I seen that long queue and everything happening, I thought it was going to be a bit of chaos, but I never showed you any of that, just because it was just too much people going round, and yeah, it was fine. It's all good. I just realised I haven't even had anything to eat yet. I haven't had any breakfast. I'm just too excited, but yeah, I need to get some food. I'm going to go to the front of the ship first, explore a bit more of the ship, take plenty more photos that I'm going to post all over social media and whatnot and share them. But yeah, can't believe I'm on a second Disney cruise, even though I booked this way, way back before the wish, but so yeah, I don't know what to say. I'm gonna go to the front, see what's going on.
I wonder if this Aquamouse, this slide is longer than the wish.
Why? It does seem like it goes a long, long way.
I'm out of the store and you're going to tell that to your maybe former meter maid with delusions of grandeur who will not be taking the case.
I just heard Officer Hobbs is taking the case.
I'm playing a film. Is it Topia, I think it's on? I don't think the weather knows what it wants to do. It starts to rain and sun and rain. Look at that. Look at the spa area over there. I may have a look at the package, see what the spa is, especially being here for a week. What's going on? Is that seagulls? I don't know if that's folks still queuing on for this ship. It might be. I came back down to deck 11. I'm going to get some food. Obviously, I'm going to get some pizza. Hi there. Can I have some pepperoni pizza, is that okay? Two, if that's okay. So I thought I'd just grab the first things I've seen really. Just to get a quick bite to eat. I don't want to sit too long and have some food, so I will come back. You can always come back and get more. But a quick sit down, quick bite to eat, and then I'm going to go and check out my room.
Oh, pizza, pizza.
It's okay. Not like warm either. Nearly cold. I like cold pizza. So I've had my quick bite to eat. And now I'm going to head down to my room. So let's head to my room. I am on the 9th floor, 9th level. I have a standard inside stateroom, which was allocated close to the time as my room number. I did not pick my room number, but I'm facing forward, so let's go and have a look at it. No veranda this time, purely because I didn't think I'd have the weather for it, and it saved some pennies. So I am 9011, and like I say, it's going to be stand up inside. Am I going the wrong way? I don't think I am. I think I'm just very far away. Hey, there I am. There I am. Oh, here we go. My bag's here as well. Right. I'm going to open this up and we'll get inside. Right, let's go. Come on, bag. Right, put the little key in the slot. We have light. Whoa! Oh, what's that? Look at this. Oh, I'm speechless. I'm just like looking at it myself. I like this. I like the. Is that camera? I'm going to put this TV off because I'll need to do the whole emergency assembly point thing. Where's the TV remote? There's there. Right. I like this. This is actually, yeah, this is cool. Very different to what I had in the Wish, of course. But my whole method behind this madness was, not madness, but method behind this was, it's two in the UK, weather-wise, price-wise. Yeah, I actually got a really good price with this. But I don't mind this at all. I do not mind not having a veranda to sit on because I'm just going to go and use the open areas, like on deck 11 and stuff. So that's the plan for me. So yeah, let's take my bag off. Let's take the bag off and have a little room tour of an inside, like a standard inside stateroom. Which to me, first impressions, I'm impressed. Right, so get the bag out of the way. Front door, let's have a look at the storage. The life jackets, hanging space, a ladder. Oh, there must be a pulled-in bed. Pulled-in bed. That probably folds out as well to a bed. The safe, oh, pulls out like that. Cool, little ducats and whatnot. So some good storage space there. Oh, some good storage space there as well. I'll come back to the bathroom shower area soon, but there's your sockets. USB points there, European socket, I believe, there. What's that? Yeah. Did that do something important? Oh. Okay. Then this one. turns on a light above the bed. That turns this light off. It's me trying to, that's what I vlog behind the scenes. That there is something. I don't know what that is. Glasses, storage area, TV. There's the TV. It's had TV tilt out so you can watch it. It does slightly. I'll pull it out, all out just now. I will update you. Well, you can. I think you can. There you go. I'm going to say update as the time goes on, but you can tilt the TV out towards the bed. The theming is, let's look at the theme. Don't have to describe it, but yeah, it's nice, really nice. This as well, you've got a curtain you can section off the bed area, this area, if you're using the pull down bed, I believe, by the looks of it. Let's go around to here, little drawers, bedside, I like that idea there that you can plug in below, pull the cable through. Still, is that real? Is that live from Southampton? Probably will be. Right. Over there, on this side of the bed. I've got the hiccups now because I've just ate too much food. Well, ate my food too quick. It wasn't too much for me. yeah, so. Really nice room. It does the job for me. Let's go inside. Ah, okay, so it's got a bath in here. Small one, albeit. I don't fit in normal bath as it is. But I like this. I get this, got everything I need. So, body lotion, all the H2O stuff, hand soap, for your sharps, for your razor blades. Towels. Like the curtain. Gotta love Disney and their theming. Shampoo, conditioner, body wash. It's not small either. I don't feel like I'm cramped in this. Yeah, I'm tall. Just mind your step here as well. Trip over that. What else? We've got a nice little chair there actually. Chair, hair dryer. What's that there? Place your heated thing. Okay. Heated items in that little bag. Here, you've got a fridge as well, which is good. I'll probably use that. Buy some water and put that in there and whatnot. So yeah, this is everything I need. This is spot on. I'll be here for seven nights on a Disney cruise. So I am going to. Sorry, I'm looking at the TV there, just telling me where my location is for the emergency point. So yeah, if it's your first time watching me, this is, if you haven't seen Disney Wish, I'm still learning the Disney Wish vlogs for myself. I'm still learning the whole Disney cruise process. I know there's videos out there that folk have been doing this for a long time and they know a lot about it. But yeah, I'm just bringing my experience and hopefully you enjoy it. So I'm going to chill just now, relax, and I will catch up with you all very, very soon. Probably at the emergency. I don't film too much of the emergency assembly area thing, but who knows. I'll just go with the flow. I'll see you all very, very soon after a bit of chill time. And I'm back. I've chilled a little bit, not for long, a couple of minutes. I actually done a separate video for the room, so that'll be up on my channel for those who are looking for information regarding a standard inside stateroom. Oh,
Attention all traffic controllers, evacuation teams and assembly teams. Oh, please report to your assembly stations and positions immediately.
So must be, what time is it? Nearly. So it's 3:30, the assembly point. I've got to go at 4:00, check in. Takes about 30 minutes. And then we're going to go to the sail away party and wave goodbye to Southampton and head on to our 7-night UK cruise. Yeah, it's all good. Anyway, what I was saying was I was going to let you know some information. I've done the video separate for the room. The information for the cruise, I just mentioned briefly there. So I'll mention the stops, but I can't remember off the top of my head. So I've got some information here. I'm going to show you the stops that I'm going to be going to. So let's have a look. So,
these are the stops. So just now, I'm in Southampton, got a day at sea, then I'm at Belfast, then Greenock, Liverpool, Cork, Portland, then back to Southampton.
Oh, it's just it's so hard to explain when you're on a Disney cruise. I mean, it was my first time doing it, last time, like I keep saying, I know. But it's very different, of course. I love Walt Disney World, I love Disneyland Paris as well. Recently just been to there as well again. Yeah, it's just something that Disney do. Everything that they do in regards to theming and immersiveness, I mention this quite a lot in my videos, but that's what gets me, that's what hooks me in, is the immersiveness and the detail. I just like all that stuff. So whether it's a theme park, a cruise, I don't know, it's just something that draws me in. It's just something about what Disney do, it's awesome. I do have a table reserved, so you get allocated tables for food. I'll see how that goes for tonight, see how I feel. I might go, I might not go. This trip for me, that's going to be a 7-night trip. There's going to be a lot of videos out there, I'm sure, about other content creators that go through every single food and every single menu and every single restaurant. There'll be lots of information out there, so I don't want to really repeat what's out there and show what's out there, because it'll be very, very similar. I want to try and do things a little bit different, so I want to try and maybe enjoy the ship a little bit more and go with the flow. That's kind of what my thoughts are for this 7 days, so as much as I can of the ship, and what else can you do, and what else can be done, and that kind of thing. So I will try and go to the restaurants. I will be hungry, I'm always hungry, but yeah, that's my kind of thought behind this. I just want to chill, nice, show a different kind of thing in regards to the cruise. But yeah, I am just like, you know, I don't know if I mentioned with the bed, so this couch sorry turns into a bed. You can just see the pillows behind. What you do is you pull that forward like that, fold that down, and you can just see the what do you call it? Mattress. No. Okay, put it back in now. Yeah, there we go. And that also comes down. But you'll need assistance with that. So yeah, I'm gonna chill for a little bit longer and then I'm gonna head to my assembly point. Let's go to assembly station A to check in for the emergency drill. So it's mandatory, this drill. I'm going back the way just now just to show you this. So this is the card that, well, the envelope that your card comes in. The key to the world card is needed. So this is your key to your world card. So you need this to unlock the door, embark and disembark, make purchases. So you can buy things just with this card because it's linked, and activate lights. So, yeah, it's time to go. I think that's what they're going to tell
me. May I have your attention, please? A mandatory emergency drill for all guests will take place today prior to sailing. Please take time to view the safety video that is now showing on your stateroom television sets. This video will demonstrate the proper method for donning your life jacket, as well as supplying general safety tips to follow while on board. The general alarm signal will be given at the beginning of the exercise. This signal consists of 7 short blasts, followed by 1 long blast of the ship's whistle and audible alarms. If the general alarm is sounded in an actual emergency, you must go directly to your stateroom, put on warm clothing and comfortable shoes, take all critical medication with you, and don your life jacket. Then proceed to your assembly station. Life jackets for each member member of your party are located on the top shelf of your stateroom closet. The life jackets come in sizes for adults, children, and infants. If you are in need of a different size than what is provided, please see your stateroom host or hostess. For those traveling with an infant, contact your stateroom host or hostess about special instructions regarding the usage of infant life jackets. Although you may hear other alarms during an emergency, you only have to respond to the general alarm. It is important that you do not use the elevators in an emergency because you could become trapped in the event of a power failure. For guests with mobility disabilities, in the event of an actual emergency, specially trained crew members will assist those who are not able to climb stairs to their assembly stations. Please do not take any food or drinks and refrain from using cell phones during this drill. If you are uncertain about the location of your assembly station, please present your key to the World Card to any of our crew and they will direct you to it. To ensure the safety of all our guests, we ask that all guests refrain from sitting on the staircases because the stairs are evacuation routes and must be clear at all times. A reminder to all. The mandatory emergency drill will take place shortly. While you are not required to wear your life jacket to the drill, your attendance is mandatory, and you must bring your key to the World Card with you in order to confirm attendance. Please arrive on time and follow the signs posted in the corridors to your lettered assembly station. Please note that all crew services will be suspended during the drill. Thank you. Attention all traffic controllers, evacuation teams, and assembly teams. You should now be at your assembly stations and positions.
Let's go. I put another card in there just because I wanted to show you the card. So I'll take that one out. I'm going to leave and go to assembly point A. So let's go to assembly point A and go through the drill, the mandatory drill.
No, we can't go that way.
Tonight, we will be sailing in westerly direction through the English Channel. The weather for this evening is forecasted cloudy skies.
I can't get less.
Don't forget about her either!
Let's give me a look!
to the sail away party. It's still kind of going off, but I've left it a little bit early to get a good spot to watch us sail away. As in, officially leave the port, but they're still at the port.
Disney Vacation Club members, a big welcome back to all of our new Pearl Tier Castaway Club members, as well as our loyal Platinum, Gold and Silver repeat cruisers. Not forgetting a special welcome aboard to our first time cruisers. We're very excited to have you on board this cruise and to be sailing to some stunning ports, with so many being a very first for the Disney Dream this season. And talking about firsts, 25 years ago our first Disney ship started sailing guests out on our magical voyages. And this cruise, we're celebrating that special milestone with some very special enhancements, such as tonight in the lobby atrium at 7:45, our 25th anniversary soiree. Now, before I get started with what's where and all the wonders.
So we are officially on our way. We have left the port. Well, technically, still in the port, but we are moving, at least. And I don't think there's many places where we can wave at people. But I'm gonna try. I'll be honest, you'd think I was in Florida right now with the weather that I'm getting. I can just feel that heat. The rain's gone for now, probably for about an hour. And the sun's out. I think there's some folk over there. Can't quite see. It looks like there's some folk waving the Disney Dream away. I can't see because of the glare of the sun. So we are turning. So we're reversed out. So we're kind of side on now. It looks like we're going to go. That's the front. It looks like we're going to go that way. I can't believe how good of a day it is. That weather changed really quickly and really on time. It was perfect, absolutely perfect. So I think we're going to turn and go in between these two buoys. Who knows? That could be the plan. I have been wrong before and I'll be wrong again. I came to the back of the ship. Look at this for a view. Sailing away. There's another ship right behind us that's popped up. That wasn't there when we left. That might have just came straight in. Or moved when we left. Like I say, the weather has just turned to be amazing. Hopefully it lasts the full duration. You never know. So there we have it. We have officially left Southampton Port. Oh, it does feel quiet though. I mean, the ship feels quiet. I'm not sure if probably famous last word saying that, but it does. I don't know. If there's reasons for that, maybe just everyone's out exploring the inside of the ship and here's me on the outside, but only because of the views. And I think that ship's actually turned now. That ship might be actually leaving as well. I don't know what's going on. I'm so confused. This cruising life confuses me. But yeah, I'm not sure what's going on and why it's as quiet as this, if there's a reason for it. Obviously there's a few activities and whatnot. Oh, it's a bit, it is windy. I'm going to go next to the table tennis. There we go. Plus there's music, sorry to watch what I'm doing with copyright.
Let me go find a quiet place. Maybe inside.
This is Goofy's sports simulator. I might give this a go during the trip. We can have a look inside, see what it looks like.
Careful with the clubs right there.
Look, wait. Yeah, it's very busy in there. I can't really get any clips. It's very small, it's just two simulators. But the plan is to get on that in there during my trip while I'm here. Can't go over how beautiful this is. I keep thinking that I'm in Florida. I don't know why. Maybe that's why. Yeah, sound off. Just came into Cabanas, which is just closed up just now. Although you can still help yourself to coffees, drinks, orange juice, etc. It's a nice vibe in here. I feel like a Nemo vibe in here. Well, what would you know? My. Right, I am going to go down to deck 3. Because I want to check out some of the shops. There's Mickey's main sale, that kind of thing. I want to get a t-shirt before they sell out, if they sell out. But it's eerily quiet on the ship. I'm not complaining, but I don't know if it is quiet or whatnot. But anyway, let's go have a look around. Mickey's main sale. Did I get a t-shirt? I am just about to buy one. Look at this. It's where I'll be. Little pocket at the front. And the price is $39.99. I do want a magnet, but I would like a dream. This is Disney Cruise Line. I would like a specific one for the dream, so I'm going to keep looking. But I have left Mickey's main sale buying that t-shirt. I'm going to go into Sea Treasures. See what's in here, see what treasures we can find. So I've ended up, just about to buy a dream, Disney Dream pin. I like it because it's got the UK on it and I'm on a UK cruise. So $18. Let's go and buy this. And I'm gonna try and not buy anything else. Yeah. So I ran away from the shops just before I start spending more money. Look at this. I'm back at the lobby again. It is very quiet and that's why I'm here and I'm having a talk over the music. It is very, very stunning. It's based on a 25-year decor as well, even though I've never been in this before. But it's still very, very beautiful. Right, so I'm going to go back to my room because I need to charge my phone and chill. And I also want to try the lift that overlooks the lobby. Look at this. Oh, look at that. There's Dumbo. Incredible. Oh. Right. Back in the room, of course. I've got a little letter here. I'm going to open it privately in case it's a secret information that I'm giving away that I can't tell yet.
So, yeah. And I am going to charge my phone. I just met Tony, who's housekeeping. Really, really nice, lovely, lovely gentleman. So yeah, I'm going to chill for a bit, charge the phone, and decide if I'm actually going to go to dinner or not. I know it sounds weird, but yeah, I'm not too sure how I feel. I'm not hungry. I'll maybe go get something to eat in Deck 11 or something. Just, yeah, if I can, if it's open, that is. If it's not, then, hey-ho. I'll just need to eat sweets. Anyway, I have to see how I feel. Still, I've got maybe 2 hours to go, so I probably will be hungry by then. But yeah, I will see you all very soon. I'm going to chill. So, yeah. I have chilled. Time has passed. My phone is charged. And it's 8 p.m. So I am going to go to the Royal Palace. That is the area for food tonight. That's my scheduled time for food. It's 8 p.m. just now. My scheduled time is 8:30. So I'm going to head up my room just now, do a little bit more exploring. If I see anything cool, I'll show you. And then I'm going to head to the Royal Palace and have some food. See how it goes. I don't know how it's going to go. Sometimes it depends where I'm seated and who I'm seated with, if I'm going to be able to record. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. And that's it. So let's get out of the room. Look how cool that is. Nighttime porthole. That's reflections of the light, as in case you're thinking that's some sort of pirate ship. That's another reflection, not an alien ship. Anyway, right, I am going to head on out of the room. Let's go. Just make sure I've got my key, got my phone, and you're good to go. So I'm going to level 3 midship, where the food is, the Royal Palace. See how busy it is at my table. If I'm able to record. I think so. I'm going to have the chicken pastilla, I think that's what you call it.
Sorry?
The chicken.
Chicken, okay, the chicken breast. The lemon, sir.
Chicken again, the grilled chicken breast.
Thank you.
Cheers, thank you. There's loads of their little jackets. I actually forgot what this was called. I think it was the chicken brioche. I think it was called.
Yeah, that's the wine.
That's the wine.
I don't know what you're going to do. I actually don't really know.
I don't think this is for cut. I think I'm going to eat it. I think I'm going to lift this up. This is... It's just like a big chicken wrap, yeah. Honestly. Quite different from Greg's.
That's good.
This one?
Oh, I'm okay. Thank you.
Pepper.
It's really good. I forgot what I don't even know what this is called again. I'm not good at this YouTube stuff, I don't know, but it's not very good, eh? Very sweet. I'm trying to figure what that is. Sun blended together is nice. Yeah.
something?
What was it, sweet potato?
Oh yeah, mate, yeah.
With something and something. Sweet corn. I know what that is, that's chicken.
Yeah.
It's a wild guess. I'm pretty sure if they asked me if I wanted to, I'm gonna have one of each, just everything. I'm gonna go for everything. Let's go for it. They'd probably give me it as well, they'd probably give me everything. No, they could. I better not joke about that because they'll probably hear me, they'll probably I'll have 14 ice creams on my table. I don't know if that's the smallest ice cream ever or if that's cream. I think it's cream. Yeah. And mango cheesecake.
Yeah.
How's the dinner tonight?
Lovely.
Lovely. You're looking for excellent. We lovely.
Just excellent? Right, okay.
We say lovely in UK, we say excellent over here on this week.
Only if you've got a good joke. Come on.
So.
That's the deal.
Let's see a puzzle.
A puzzle?
Yeah.
Right, okay.
Not a puzzle. Just a Romeo and Juliet died. And they died. Listen, there was a fish present at the gift dance. There was a bowl and water. Broken bowl and a water.
That's a joke?
No.
Sorry. Puzzle.
Joke? Only Edson can do,
sir. What?
Edson, you know my colleague? He's the best at telling jokes. Edson, gentleman needs a joke.
Yeah.
A joke.
A joke?
Yes.
Me?
Yes.
So what's the story then? What's the story?
So the story, it's a puzzle. If you solve this, Romeo and Juliet died.
Right.
And there was water and a broken glass.
This is a riddle.
It's a riddle.
A riddle, not a problem.
Solve it. How did it die? Riddle.
There's a bottle and a...
Glasses, broken glasses.
Broken glass.
Right. And Romeo and Juliet died.
They fell on the bottle?
No. Romeo and Juliet died.
Yeah.
Next to them, there was water and broken glasses. How did that happen?
Did they drink something that wasn't water?
No. Madam knows, right? No? They were fish. Name Romeo and Juliet. Two fish.
That's a joke, that's not even... That's more of a joke. Oh dear. He's a wee laughing himself. He's all proud.
I'll just round the corner from it. So since tomorrow is a day at sea, I think I'm going to have a chill day watching some movies. Even a show tonight at the Buena Vista Theatre, Indiana Jones, at 10:45. That's in half an hour. I might even go and watch that. So it's just in there. In Buena Vista Theatre. Yeah, I may explore level 4 just now, deck 4, and come back and watch that because tomorrow is a day at sea, so it's a long lie tomorrow.
I've walked right up to the top, and because I'm so tall, I can touch the ceiling, and they say that's because it makes children or younger ones feel like they're taller. I think that's what it is. But just look at this view. I mean, I'm going to turn around so you can see the whole view. It's not the best weather to be outside right now. It's been pouring down, but I'm on a Disney cruise ship, and look at that behind me. So, cheers. I'm going to take some photos. It's very windy. I'm getting a bit cold. I think I'm actually going to call it a night. Yeah, it's kind of 10:30. I think I'm going to push it. If I go to watch a movie, I think I'll end up probably falling asleep. Look at that, like, someone's got a Mickey hanging up. Anyway, we'll go back to my room. Let's go. I feel like there's a fish. That's a fish there. Wait, oh, we're locked again. That was quick. Wait, go, 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 go. Oh, right. Oh. I've got the drink in my hand as well. Ta-da! I need to get a magic band. Right, what's going on here? Try not to slam my door here. To be honest. Oh. Don't want to slam the door. What have we got going on here? I'm not even going to guess. Is that a starfish? It's the best guess. And chocolate. I know what that is. I know what chocolate is. And it's pitch black outside. Yeah, I'm going to get settled. Yeah, it's official. I am going to end the night there. It is coming up for... Is it, what time is it? 10:30? I'll just throw my phone in bed here. It is 10:45. So, yeah, that's not going to focus. If I wanted to go watch that movie just now, I could. And get a long lie tomorrow, or I could just go to sleep just now, like I might do. Probably going to fall asleep straight away. And I'm not going to get up early, but it's a day at sea tomorrow, so I'm all day on the ship. I'll go check other things out. I want to try and buy a Disney Dream t-shirt. I couldn't find a specific Disney Dream t-shirt, so I'm going to try and look for that and spend more money. But today, to recap, has been a successful day. I stayed yesterday over at the hotel, the Grand Harbour Hotel. You can't walk, so if this Disney ship or future Disney ships is always at the QE2, the Queen Elizabeth 2 terminal, then I would not suggest walking to that terminal. There's other options, I believe there's bus options and whatnot, I think, but I got an Uber. You've seen that today. That was £6 for an Uber. Highly recommend that. Takes you straight into the terminal, enclosed, not outside, inside, and you're straight in. So I'd highly recommend that. Drop your bags in. So it was too hectic. I was trying to learn myself and what was going on. So look for the bag drop first if you're looking to drop bags in yourself, like I did. So I dropped the bags off, and then I went into the queue. The first queue you go into is like a general queue, and then they tell you what queue to go in for your time slot. So that's why I recommend going in early. I arrived pretty early, maybe an hour and a half early, maybe an hour early, and they put me into the 1 p.m. queue. So it's different queues. It was like 12:30, 12:45, 1 p.m. and they put me into that queue. My queue started getting longer and longer and longer. So that's why I suggest getting in, get into the general queue, get into your queue, stand and wait, and then you're straight into the check-in. Get checked in, do as much, so do all the check-in online as much as you can, even the health questionnaire, and then it's a quick process. And then I got my wristband. Not too sure what that's for. I think do I need to wear that for the full trip, for the full 7 days? I presume so. I think it's just identify who you are, if you're going off the ship and on the ship and whatnot, I don't know. We'll find out. But yeah, got on the ship, explored the ship. Not a lot to see really when we're leaving the port. It's pretty industrial. There's not a lot to kind of watch, but the weather was fantastic, and then it turned again to horrible. But yeah, had a good walk round. Bought that t-shirt's pretty cool. Like I say, I want to get another kind of, so I've got this Wish t-shirt. I want something like this for a dream, so there will be something there, so I'm gonna have a look. The got the pin as well. Went to Royal Palace for food was nice, it was okay. It's the theming. I'm not too sure about I know it's the kind of princess theme, but there was no characters going round that I could see anyway, but I couldn't see anything. No music playing. I don't know. There was pictures on the kind of walls and stuff. But yeah, not a lot of theming. Staff are great. Staff are fantastic. And yeah, really enjoyed that side of it. The staff were funny and interactive, and that was great, so I like that. And then, as you've seen, I just explored the ship a little bit, seen outside, seen what it's like at night time. I did contemplate going to watch Indiana Jones, but yeah, I'll probably end up falling asleep in the theatre. But it is on again during this trip, so I'm not going to do everything in the one day, and this is longer than my last trip, so I'm going to, yeah, just pace myself, and we'll go off on a few ports and a few adventures as well. So I'm going to end the video there. Thank you all for watching. If you've watched all the way through, I do appreciate it. Hit subscribe, show your support, help the channel grow, and get the information and share the video out there to people that are looking for this information to plan their trip as well. So thank you all for watching. Thank you all for the comments and messages. Let's go around the UK and explore. So join me in the next video. I hope you're all well. Until next time, I'll see you then.